A letter for me.
The train's ours now. May as well make ourselves at home.
Thank you.
A letter for me.
Good day, sir. Nigel went out drinking with a gang last night. They ran up against some.
Thank you. Templars and Kiltland. But Nigel was too sozzled to get away. Knew the constables have him up for murder.
This is going to go bad for you. Confess, and you'll save us all some grief.
Oh, I didn't do nothing. So help me, Bob! Miss Evie, we kept buying drinks. The next thing I know, they say I burnt someone.
Oh, Nigel.
I had one too many and lost all my things. They must be scattered all about. Oh, and there's a knife out there too. Could you get him before the Rosses do?
Get there! Shut up!
Ah, smugglers, lucky I'm trying to keep out of trouble. Next day behind bars will be my last. Still, it'll be worth it to upend that low life. What made you think that was a good idea?
What's all that then?
Oddities of the human behavior.
Don't kill me, please!
I beg you!
Have mercy! Please!
It doesn't have to be this
way! What is the meaning?
Please,
I'll do anything you want. Just let me live.
You there! What do you know of this?
The coppers, truly we are lifelines. Due
to all these gangs everywhere.
They've never to guess the Arab.
What are the police?
Where's the police?
Madam, this is your final warning.
I'm
Warning you, young lady. Stop. That's quite close enough.
Straighten you out. Let's see.
What the dickens?
Better have a look. I see what you're up to. Don't make me come over there.
Thank you. Find a knife if I'm not mistaken.
I just saw something hereabouts. Where on earth did it disappear to?
Thank you. Spend the night in jail, you will. As soon as I see you.
What was that? I better investigate.
Believe in ghosts.
What evidence are you holding this man?
Why, on, Sergeant?
I believe at a minimum you need a body.
We can't find a thing, Inspector.
You botched another one, Sergeant.
Nice to see you again, Mr. Dickens. Is it time for another of the Ghost Club stories?
As a matter of fact, yes. Follow me.
I love men in uniform.
Number 50, Berkeley Square. Four stories high and branded, Beware All Those Who Enter. There have been many strange tales of this dreadful domicile. The earliest report of a haunting was said to be the specter of a small girl who was murdered by a servant. She could be seen at the attic windows, weeping and wringing her little hands in an agony of despair. Come along. The house awaits. You're not afraid, are you?
Hmm.
I'm eager to begin. You're not afraid, are you? To escape her abusive uncle. Her screaming ghost has reportedly been sighted hanging from the window ledge. This residence was briefly owned by a Mr. James Jasper, a choir master and an opium addict. His nephew Edward was betrothed to one of Mr. Jasper's pupils, the fair and delicate Rose. However, Edward disappeared under mysterious circumstances, followed by Jasper himself. Perhaps grief sent him back to the soothing arms of his narcotic mistress.
Faster! Come on! Tara! Easy now.
Shall we? Though this house is vacant, some say it comes alive at night with screams of terror, ringing bells, and slamming shutters. Although eerie, this phenomenon is easily produced by pneumatic tubes and valves. There are claims that a young man was caged in the attic. His only connection to the rest of the world, a tiny hole in the door. A young man who was reduced to madness by this extreme isolation. The legends all seem to focus on one room in particular. A sudden draft, nothing more. Perhaps I shall wait here while you investigate the source of that laughter, which is not at all unsettling.
Now tell.
I've found a lock, but I haven't located the key.
It's here.
So this is how it works.
Impressive.
Get out of my house!
Stand back, Charles.
There was no one whose love for Rosa came near to equaling mine. It should have been enough to keep my beloved nephew away. My poor Ned. Forgive.
Alas, the myth has been discredited. There was no ghost in Berkeley Square, just a wretched soul driven to murder and madness by guilt and intoxication. I think this has the makings of a rather fine novel. I wonder if I've got one left in me.
Something's out there.
Thank you.
and slip through the cracks.
In the old city. You have a pleasant day now.
hiding spot.
Not the manliest thing to do, hiding like that, is it?
Some odd bods in this town.
Sir, what are you doing here? Shh. He's hiding.
What a peculiar fellow.
Being attacked!
someone! I'm being attacked! God! What? Unhand me, wretch!
I let you live.
Can't you see I'm busy?
Settle down, Mr. King. Hush. Don't want to draw attention to yourself, do you?
What is the meaning of this? Gods, help me!
Take your load off at the bed and bottle. Once you come, you'll never want to leave.
Thank you.
yourself scarce.
Terminus for you, my friend.
He understands that he remains visible.
Looks like he's got a screw loose.
Little Master Daniel.
maybe instilling a bit of fear in their hearts would do the trick. Of a missing friend.
What's he doing here?
Did Clara send you, mister? Ain't she wonderful?
Thank you.
God in heaven. Bloody hell, you still owe me a pony.
It'll be all right.
Thank you, sir.
Grab him! Drag him out!
Thank you. keep quiet. I'm here to help.
Much appreciated, mister.
Keep your voice down.
You saved us!
Have a good day now.
away with these Fry twins. They're nothing but trouble to the Blighter organization. We have recently received a shipment of new pistols from our leader, Mr. Lynch. After supper, please come and see the distribution. Surely help us defeat those damned rooks. I do so long.
That wasn't in my head. You see him? He should be here.
These new surely help us defeat those damned rooks.
Away with this nuisance.
people of London, are you tired of breaking your back in factories all day and most of the night? Are you tired of coming home to sleep on the floor with an empty belly? My friends, we must...
Quiet, Miss Duke. There's time for talking later.
And what do the coppers want from me this time?
How do you know I'm with the police?
Aye, with all the tactics they've tried, nothing surprises me anymore. They want me for the countless crimes I've committed, but they never hold me for long.
Peter the Conqueror. Peter the Great. Achilles was. I will be great and powerful, and I will live on forever in the minds of the weak.
There's a lot of unusual folk about today.
I'll come over there and deal with you, kid!
Not much of a hiding spot, if we can see him.
I should probably pretend I can't see that.
Nothing surprises me anymore.
That's your criminal element, that is.
It will have to wait. From now on, everyone will remember Peter Needham. Peter the Strong. Peter the Conqueror. Peter the Great. I will be great and powerful, and I will live on forever in the minds of the weak.
I'm not interested in losing my head here.
Someone must have fled Lambeth Asylum.
This is it. This is my moment.
I give you the rights!
Boo! Boo!
Rich boodles! What gives you the rights?
From now on, everyone will remember Peter Neely. Peter the Strong. Peter the Conqueror. Peter the Great.
You can't do this to us!
Will be new again.
I'll behave, yeah?
Still, this is London.
Smash the machines! Power to the workers! We stand
Stark raving mad. He don't know if he's hiding or spying.
What are you hoping to achieve, my lady?
There's something wrong, laddie.
Some fellows are just plain strange.
He's hiding from someone, that's for sure. Best not to...
Oh!
Hush, Mr. Fowler. Quiet down.
What in God's name was that for?
Spying on another print house, are we?
Was not. All right, maybe I was. But I'm tired of everyone getting what they want besides me. Nobody ever asked old Gilbert what he wanted.
Save it for the sergeant, Fowler.
Mr. Lynch has agreed to your terms. In exchange, he will be fighting with electrochemical bombs. He sends his highest regards and encourages you to bring your bravery.
Fight! I'm your prayers in order!
Jacob and Evie Fry. And as of this moment, you are working.